sin basically builds around the false power, false knowledge. Yes, that's why in the book of Hosea chapter 4 verse 6, the prophet said, my people are perishing due to lack of knowledge, real knowledge of who they are. So sin basically takes us away from the presence of God. That's why we have a beautiful psalm which says, Psalm 146 verse 4 says, when his spirit departs, man returns to his earth. In that very day, all his plans perish. The moment he loses the presence of God by holding on to something, all my plans which God had kept for me, with a great plan, my God sent me into the world. But when I hold on to sin, moving away from the presence of God, I lose every plan of God. The plan of God perishes. That's what we read in the book of Judges chapter 16 verse 20. He thought, Samson thought, like any other time, first time I have sinned, nothing happened to me. Second time I have sinned, nothing has happened to me. Now also he got used to moving away from the presence of God and playing with the world. The Bible says, those of the Bible, can you read 16:20?
Then she said, the Philistines are upon you, Samson. When he awoke from his sleep,
he thought,
I will go out as at other times.
Like other times, now also, just I will move away from here. He thought.
And shake myself free.
And I will set myself free, he thought.
But he did not know. That the Lord had left him.
You can't play with the sin for long. The Bible says, do not quench your spirit. Do not put the Lord into test. Do not grieve the Holy Spirit who trusted in and stays in you. The Bible wants us, don't play with the sin. Don't hurt the Holy Spirit who has loved you and made your body his temple, and he is staying with you. Don't hurt him. Don't grieve him. And when we hurt the Holy Spirit through our bodies, instead of, as we read in Isaiah 43 verse 7, I have created them to bring glory to me. Instead of bringing glory, throwing away our life for anything and everything, what happens? The Lord's Spirit left Samson. The Lord's Spirit left Samson. The moment the Spirit of the Lord left him, the enemies got the power to catch him, pluck away his eyes, tie his hands and feet with the chains, and Samson died a horrible death. Sin basically means Satan managing to take us away from the presence of God and making us to believe that which is perishing as real and tying us up with that we lose sight of that which is eternal, that which is life-giving. We move away from that which is eternal and life-giving and throw ourselves into that which is perishing, that which is death. That's what Satan could be able to manage to do in the lives of many people. When God had a wonderful plan of saving the world and anointed the great servant of God called Jonah. I don't think any other servant in the whole of Bible had that kind of anointing, that with one sermon, one day work, he could transform 1.5 lakh of people to repent for their sins and to return to God. Such an anointing God had endowed with Jonah. But sin means basically taking us away from the plan and presence of the Father into that which is perishing. So Jonah went away from God and he was thrown into the sea. But the mercy of God brings him out of that. But again he goes away from the Lord. Second time, third time, then the Lord says, it's very difficult to work with you as you wish. The story of Jonah ends in the middle. We don't know what happened to him. Sin is basically making man to believe that which is perishing as eternal, that which is killing you as pleasure for you. We read in the Gospel of John, chapter 13, verse 30. When God, the Lord Jesus, trusted Judas, out of 72 disciples, he chose 12 as his own, close to him, to teach the eternal secrets. And Judas is one among them. And among all the 12, he trusted him to carry the money. He trusted all the more. But when he received little money, he thought that is life. He forgot the giver of the gifts. He identified himself with the gifts. And he threw himself to the gifts. And he sold his life for that gifts. The tragedy is, the moment we move away from the presence of God, when we are into the hands of the enemy, he is capable enough to make man to throw himself or herself into a lower way of life, and whereby to shame the Lord who has created the man. Oh God, you created this fellow. You created this lady. Look at her life. Look at him. Where they are. And Judas received the bread and the wine from the master. Verse 30 says, he went away from Jesus. The moment he went away from Jesus, it became dark. Darkness covered him. We read in the Gospel of Matthew, Peter came to meet Jesus, but the eyes of Peter was captured by the enemy. So he saw the coal of fire and the people enjoying, having little pleasure with that fire, warming up their bodies. The eyes of Peter was captured. Now the body of Peter was captured. And Peter left Jesus and he went to the fire to be burnt. And there he is with those women. When they asked him, were you not with the Lord? He denied them. And one of the ladies, the Bible says, caught hold of his outer garment. He left the outer garment and runs naked. when you lose the master, move away from the master, what is the fate of man? As long as we hold on to the master, we have life. That's why I repeat 1 John 5:12, he who has the son has life, he who doesn't have the son has no life. The enemy plays havoc through the sin means managing to take us away from the master and away from the work to glorify the master, away from that which is eternal and throw us into that which is perishing and tying us into that perishing and making us to believe in that and die in that filth and thinking that is the pleasure, until one day we realize we are completely destroyed. Until one day we realize it's better to hang and die. That's what Judas thought. Sin basically is the trick of the enemy to take us away from the master and to tie up ourselves with that which is non-eternal, which is perishing, which is filthy. And it threw away the prodigal son with the pigs.